Welcome back. We are doing Women in the Know. It is our segment where we discuss everything from politics and policy, relationships and marketing, to franchise growth and difficulties between franchisees and franchisors. One topic that we have been on lately is grit. We've been doing a little bit of a series on that. And one of the elements of grit that we're going to talk about today is adaptability and how that impacts success. Rebecca? You want to start us off with your thoughts on that?
Oh, adaptability. You know, they say the older you get, the less flexible you are. And I think there's some reality to it. But as a scientist, having studied this thing called grit for a number of years, adaptability is a huge component of success. And it's vital for us, especially during times of crises, to be able to adapt in our thought processes and our strategies and how we spend our day and reprioritize things. So I thought it was interesting in our segment on Where Passion and Purpose Collide, when we were talking to Susan and Sherry, both franchisees with Mr. Transmission, how they seemed to just be ducked to water with change. They went, you know, Susan went from being a flight attendant for American Airlines to running a transmission shop. And then Sherry, coming from the world of the medicine, choosing then to go into running her own transmission shop with her husband. That required huge adaptability and flexibility. But I think the key that I walked away with in talking with them is both of them had a passion for learning. And I think that in and of itself allows us to be more adaptable. When we really are endlessly curious and we want to expand our minds and we enjoy learning, then it's easier to change and to adapt. So they both seem to exhibit that. And I think it's a common thing that we probably see with people that are better at adapting to situations, is this willingness to learn and maybe even master something new.
I think that's so true and so interesting. And while you're talking, I'm thinking about, both women are of similar ages, I think, but they're both at different stages of franchising in terms of experience. One is a year in, one is 25 years in. And Susan said something about, well, I took the chance when I was much younger. And I'm thinking, my oldest son was the worst for change. He hated change. He didn't want to move. High school was, you know, it was scary. But he's gotten better at it. So I'm trying to decide, do you think that people are more or less adaptable when they're younger or older? Is there a trend there, or is it individual?
You know what? I think you're probably right. It's probably more individual. There's no doubt. I mean, there's a reason that we stereotype people and say older people are less flexible. Mm-hmm. But I think you're right. I think the young people could be just as equally inflexible and lack adaptability as older people. I think it really, maybe it is more of an attitude, a mental place.
Yeah,
right.
It's a personality trait. You've got the daredevils, and
yeah,
you've got the conservative people who don't want to try anything new. And I think that that probably runs across the gamut. But I like your pointing out the passion for learning, because I do think this is one of the common things you see in successful people in franchising is the passion for learning, but also the passion for self-actualization and constant improvement in self. I mean, so many people that we interview talk about reading self-improvement books, going to conferences to learn more. They don't want to stagnate. Mm-hmm. And so that trait alone would encourage you to be more adaptable, because you don't want to stay in the same place all the time.
Yeah, and Susan Trumbull actually hit just that. She says, I'm successful, I am at peace, I'm respected in my community, I love what I do, but there's always room to learn something new, and there's always another goal that she's going after. And of course, to do that requires additional skills and flexing certain muscles that we haven't flexed before. So it's a kind of this, and we talked about this in grit, it's this wonderful balance of willingness to adapt, because I'm curious and I want to learn, but also having a certain drive that says, I haven't arrived yet. I haven't arrived yet. Heather Hudson talked about that in our last session also. Always wanting to do a little bit better, which requires oftentimes pushing ourselves out of our comfort zone, either learning something new, doing something different. It requires that.
Well, it does. And I think I've mentioned this before, the best advice somebody ever gave me was dream bigger. You sometimes get singularly focused on one thing and how you're going to follow this one path that you've laid out for yourself. And someone says, Well, just dream bigger. I mean, why are you limiting yourself to that? And having that in you, I mean, I think about that a lot. Most days I think about that, I think, because if you think something's going to end here or we're going to accomplish this there, then what's the bigger dream, you know? And I think that being conscious of that and not being limiting to yourself, you can get in, we all get in ruts, we all get stuck, you know, we all have stagnant periods, but to have an overarching theme of dream bigger, kind of pushes you into that need to adapt as well.
It sure does. You know, we're so smart.
We say that every week.
We're just so smart.
Now we need other people to say it.
That's right. That's right. Well, we do need to wrap up this portion of Women in the Know. Join us again next week as we dive deep in some other fabulous topics.
Yeah, and we'll tell you how much we know about something else, right? We'll figure it out. We'll solve the problems in 5 minutes.
Chop, chop.
Chop, chop. All right. We'll be back next time.